Gujarat. Gujarat has got a lot of potential for irrigation. about 1.5 for the 4.5 million, 10 comes to Madhya Pradesh, then Maharashtra. In fact, Gujarat has got more from that from Maharashtra for the drip irrigation. And southern states less than 1 million, sorry, yes, about 7 lakh, yes, 5 million. And this is mini sprinkler. The mini sprinkler we use mostly for your garlic, potato, groundnut, and then onion, like that, toss such a crop, and then blue soil, like the powder crops in blue soil, they respond very well to micro irrigation. And this is a contribution compared to less, so only around 2.5 million acres. And I can tell you when I see the crop wise, you see, cereals, potential of cereals are 21-22 million acres, pulses, oilseeds, cotton. Oilseeds are natural because of groundnut. Then cotton comes from sugarcane, is in the present more than cotton. Fusion foods are for this is the crop wise distribution for potentiality in different places on a unit basis. When you see the distribution among the whole this one, you can see the north and northeastern, northern portion is more for sprinklers. Whereas the southern and southeast eastern portion is more for drip, and the central area is more sprinkler and drip, potentially are more almost same. Then we have also done for every state what is the potentiality. Suppose you take Andhra Pradesh, what is 1.3 million? Like that, what is the difference for different systems and what are the crops? Like that, they happen for all the states. And for certain states like Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Chhattisgarh, they have also looked at the district level and district level what are the different potentialities. Those are the problems. Now, with this, when you see the adoption as on today, the adoption, as on March 2012, the total micro irrigation, we have got about 6 million hectares have been covered by micro irrigation in India. Out of the 6 million, these 10 states, we start with Haryana, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, that is 3 southern states, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal. These 10 states contribute 96%. You see, Uttar Pradesh, nothing is there. They are doing very, very poor in Uttar Pradesh. Where can we come to drip? It is still one thing, only these 6 states are doing it. All are living with them, other states are living with this. 93% are from these 6 states. You see, maximum is of course in Maharashtra, then Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat. These are the 3 major states coming up to the drip. When it comes to sprinkler, again, see, double. You see, as well as this one, the total micro irrigation thing, everyone feels that Maharashtra is the first major state in micro irrigation. But in reality, it is Rajasthan, which is being 11.5 million hectares, 11.5 lakh hectares, and Andhra Pradesh is 11.1 lakh hectares. Okay? Out of the 11 lakh hectares is only sprinkler in Rajasthan. That means the difference. Now, otherwise, you can see all these are 4 again. Rather than 11, the next comes the Haryana 5. All these are 4 again. So, this is the position for the sprinkler. Now, crop-wise, you see, out of the all this distribution, 70%, the maximum is 90% in citrus. 70% also citrus is a major, single major crop, contributing to 70% of the revenue in this one. That is followed by banana 12%. And then 10% is this one. Now, the IWMI-TATA program, they have taken the survey of 9 states, where these are working. This one, and they took 150 farmers for each state as a sample, and they did all the works. I had to look into the time constraint, I had to find that net income. If you see in all places, the getting done makes some sun stabilizers, the small farmers are getting more retained done, the sun states, the large farmers getting more income. But on the average, 15,000 to 20,000 rupees, they get more than income to retain. On annualized cost basis. This annualized cost basis. And this is for the other states, Gujarat. Gujarat was 14, 19, and 20. Whereas Gujarat is more. See, it depends on the crop also, and which crop we are doing it. So all those things are very important. So much of the... Though you may be happy that the area has come under the irrigation, but yet the purpose of the irrigation is not becoming achieved. Because the carbon is the potential water saving that can achieve. That is the example of Gujarat. Our 60% of water saving should be there in the forest field. But the survey conducted says over 25% to 40% water is being saved. So the 20% gap is still there. That means that the farmer has to be educated as to the exact quantity of water he has to use. That is the problem. Still the farmers are more educated. And then the IWMI has come up. They have made three states they have found that where it is occupied. The JPMI, GGRC and the Maharashtra supplies are playing. Where the GGRC is Gujarat, the income of the GGRC. In GGRC, I think there's a good separate percentage for GGRC. So I don't go much into that. But the central donor agency, exclusively meant for micro irrigation, is going to be the best answer for popularization of the micro irrigation in India. Now, why we are not in India? I went to the last slide where I would like to take the issues and strategies. First is affordability by farmers. Though you give 50% subsidy, some people are not at the government of the government is 100%. You tell the federal government to pay everything. And 80%, 90% they are giving. Even the farmers are not able to come. But the affordability is to pay farmer, more economical design. See, now, for the soil type, at the industrial society in all the states, interested in the soil type, the impulse has given us to 40 centimeter or 60 centimeter. Whereas in clay soil, you can go even up to 1 meter. That's not a big problem. Whereas in 75, 40 centimeter is fine. So that type of differentiation you make, the clay soil people, where many clays are there, the deficit can be considered brought up. Because the repair process is quite high. So that can be done. Then the advantage is, we can go for diamond blending, you want to make all the different crops to go for diamond blending. Sugar cane diamond blending is done. So in the plant row, instead of going to one more lateral for each row, you reduce the row placing of the plants and put one lateral so that you can take at least 40% of the system cost can be brought down. But the other thing is, some agriculture seems to care, and throw down the low cost of this equation. If you ask the normal distributor, normally it costs you over 9 meters by 10 meters to keep. It costs over 70,000 rupees more. Or 70,000 rupees. But at least you have 50,000 rupees you can get. So that kind of low cost system can be done. Then the other important thing is the education. Now the farmers, they want personal places. Many farmers apply also personal places. But they are not really costly. So the real education is not giving up. But there are ways where the present fertilizer itself which we are using can be used as a marshal fertilizer. So that type of technology should be done. The second is subsidy policy. The subsidy policy automatically is a very important one. See, now the whole subsidy is being given by a unit cost that is decided by the government of India, which they do once in 5 years. And that also they take 2 years to completely finalize the cost of the start today, it takes 2 years to complete. So by the third year, the farmer is getting a subsidy amount. But by the way, because of the petroleum cost, the subsidy actually when it gets, it comes to only 30 to 35%. So the subsidy cost should be reduced periodically. When the GCS is they have developed a software where every 6 months or whatever time we fix up, when the petroleum cost increases, automatically the software will calculate the cost, unit cost. And when the petroleum price reduces, the unit cost will be reduced. So that's some type of arrangement at a national level we have to get. Generally a farm will get nearly 30% subsidy. Always is getting 30% only. Then informality of subsidy for all crops, rationalization of subsidy for sprinklers. Now we have seen the sprinkler, many farmers, no matter they use of cotton, they are going for sprinklers. Sugar cane, they are going for sprinklers because the single sprinkler is only 80,000 rupees per hectare. Whereas drink the sugar cane costs more, but efficiency wise, certainly it is far better than sprinklers. And we should go or we should be only for a more efficient system. So when you keep both sprinkler and drip, say 50% subsidy, naturally people are going for sprinklers. So there is need to think, rethink on the subsidy for sprinkler to bring it down to 20 level. So that the amount can go for good. There is no flow of funds is very important. Here we give the program plan to the central government and they release the money somewhere in December 10th suppose. And then the farmer is paying it automatically. So it takes in the once 5 years you should give the program and they should periodically release the money. And after 3rd year they can again revisit the program to give it. Then human resource development, training operation makers to form, this is very important that we have to do it. Then for that trainer training, which ministers have taken up, the aim of the underground education is very important. For that the local agriculture development will be developed, the irrigation practices are used, Karnataka passing Palanisami exams in the top to go on that. Then this is really important. Single autonomous nodal agency dedicated for implementation of only all organizations in the state like India, Gujarat. Like that, every state should have that.